Jai Hind everyone. Today I am going to talk about an Indian revolutionary and an unsung hero who has sacrificed his life for our independence. His name is Vishnu Ganesh Pingle. Vishnu Pingle was born in the year 1888, 2nd of June, to a Marathi Brahmin family near Pune district of the Bombay Presidency. He started studying at the Maharashtra Vidyalaya, where he greatly came under the influence of the nationalist movement. During his childhood, Pingle was even very much influenced by the Japanese handloom industry. He therefore even started his small Swadeshi handloom business at Auza in Maharashtra. This was during the Swadeshi movement. However, Pingle's dream was to be an engineer. Therefore, in the year 1911, he flew to the United States of America. Over there, Pingle very much resonated with the American War of Independence. In the year 1912, Pingle even got himself enrolled as a student of mechanical engineering from the University of Washington. Despite his extraordinary accomplishments and achievements, Pingle never went behind wealth or fame. His only wish was to free our country from the British rule. After reaching America, Vishnu Ganesh Pingle was introduced to Satyan Bhushan Sen and other Gadar leaders. Let me tell you what Gadar was. Gadar was an international political movement founded by the expatriate Indians to overthrow the British rule in India. In the year 1914, month of October, Pingle, along with other Sikh revolutionaries, totally 8,000 of them, sailed from America. Pingle then halted in China for a few weeks in order to meet some Gadar leaders. He was then sent to Calcutta in the month of November 1914. Pingle was introduced to Jatin Mukherjee at Calcutta. He also had long talks with him. Later, Vishnu Ganesh Pingle was sent to meet Raj Bihari Bose in order to convey some valuable information. Pingle and other Gadar leaders went across different states of India, meeting different people, and even Pingle halted several weeks at Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, and had a hectic life. Preparing bombs and explosives was an explicit part of the Gadar movement. Therefore, Pingle, along with his other leaders, had to move to different places in India in order to collect the materials for making these explosives. However, their attempt in overthrowing the British out of India was unsuccessful. Nevertheless, this instilled a strong sense of patriotism and nationalism in the fellow Gadar members and other Indians. Later, Vishnu Ganesh Pingle was arrested by a person called Nadir Khan. He was falsely accused of possessing bombs and explosives along with him. A reporter, Vishnu Sharma, also accused him of having 300 bombs with him. Therefore, he was arrested and taken to the Meerut jail. There, his mother visits him. Vishnu Ganesh Pingle touches his mother's feet and tells her, "Ma, faltu mein vakilo ko paisa mat dena. Ye log hume fansi dene wale hai." His mother shreds in tears and questioned him, "Mere bete, kya tujhe maut se dar nahi lagta kya?" Vishnu Ganesh Pingle tells his mother that, "My last and only wish is to free our country from the British rule." He also tells that, "Is janm mein to matrubhumi ka karz chuka lo. Agle janm mein fir se tere pet mein janm lunga aur tera karz chukaunga." Vishnu Ganesh Pingle, before he was hanged, he prayed to God that, "God, we are sacrificing our lives to protect our country. Now, it is your duty to save our country and protect it." Vishnu Ganesh Pingle was hanged at the Lucknow Central Jail on 16th of November 1915. He also has a street named after him at the Central Mumbai. An individual may die for an idea, but that idea, after his death, incarnates in 1,000 other lives. Quoted by Netaji Bose, holds true for the revolutionary Vishnu Ganesh Pingle. Bharat Mata ki Jai, Vande Mataram.